Good morning, my dear students. Kailash Chandrapanda welcomes you to a new English environment. In this episode, we will go through a new poem, The Solitary Reaper. In this video, we will discuss about the poet, the background of the poem, the meaning of important words and phrases, the substance of first three stanzas, and the important questions and their answers. Before coming to the poem, let's first discuss about the poet. Poetry is the breath and finer spirit of knowledge. Can you say, students, whose version is this? You must say, he is nobody but the eminent poet of the Romantic age, William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was born on 7th April 1770. He is regarded as a poet of nature. He belonged to the Romantic age of English literature. He wrote about ordinary men and women in the language of the ordinary people. The name of his poem collections are Guide to the Lakes, The Lakes, The Journals of Dorothy, and Daffodils and Other Poems. He died in the United Kingdom on 23rd April 1850. Now come to the background of the poem. Once the poet had a visit to the highlands of Scotland. While going to the destination, through a valley, he heard the sweet voice of a maiden. He saw a solitary reaper cutting and binding the crops and singing by herself. The voice impressed him very much. The everlasting beauty and sorrow are the two major themes of the poem. It is written in a ballad form. Now come to the first stanza of the poem. Behold her single in the field, yon solitary highland lass, reaping and singing by herself. Stop here or gentle pass. Here, behold means to see. Solitary means the state of being alone. Here, yon means over there. Reaping means cutting the grains. Highland lass means a girl of the mountain region of Scotland. It is said that Scotland is divided into two parts, highland and lowland. While passing through the highland of Scotland, the poet comes upon a young girl reaping and singing by herself. The poet requests his passers-by to see her. He also tells them to enjoy the sweet voice of the girl or go away slowly without disturbing her. Now let's discuss some important questions and their answers from the introduction and the first stanza. First question, who is the poet of the poem The Solitary Reaper? The answer is William Wordsworth. Now come to the second question. What was Wordsworth passing through? Here the answer is a valley of Scotland. Next question. Whom does the poet see while passing through the hills? The answer is a young Scottish farmer girl. Next question. What was the girl doing? The answer is reaping and singing by herself. The next question, who does the poet ask to behold the girl? The answer is the passers-by. What does the poet tell the passers-by? Your answer will be to stop or pass gently. Next question. Why does Wordsworth tell the passers-by to pass gently? He doesn't want the girl to be disturbed. Now let's discuss the second stanza. Alone she courts and binds the grain and sings a melancholy song. Oh, listen, for the voice profound is overflowing with the sound. Here bind means tie or fasten together. Melancholy strain means sad strong. Here vale refers to the valley. Profound means deep and wide. Overflow means flooded with. You can also say covered with. The girl was alone. She was cutting and binding the grains and at the same time singing by herself. The tune of the song was sad. The poet attracts the attention of the passers-by that the deep valley is overflooded with the sweet voice of the girl. Now come to the first question of the stanza. What is the girl doing while reaping the grain? The answer is singing by herself. Next question. What sort of song is the girl singing? The answer is a sad song. Now move to the third question. What do you mean by melancholy strain? The answer is sad song. Next question. What was flooded with the beautiful voice of the girl? The answer is the entire deep valley. Now come to the third stanza. No nightingale did ever chant more welcome notes to weary bands of travelers in some shady haunts among Arabian sands. Nightingale, we know, is a small European singing bird. Here chant means sing and welcome means pleasant, that attracts the attention of somebody. Note means song. Weary band means a group of tired travelers, and haunt means a place frequently visited, and shady haunt means the oasis of Arabian desert, a place with water and trees in the desert. Arabian sand means the desert of Arab. The poet is so much impressed by the sweet voice of the solitary reaper that he says, it is sweeter than the voice of the nightingale, whose song feasts the ears of the tired travelers in the oasis of the Arabian desert. No doubt, the heart of the tired travelers are filled with joy to hear the nightingale's welcome notes, but the girl's voice says, surpasses the bird's song in sweetness. Now the first question of the stanza. Which bird sings welcome notes? The answer is nightingale. Next question. Who does the nightingale attract by its sweet voice? The answer is the tired travelers or nomads of the Arabian desert. Now come to the next question. Where do the tired travelers of the desert hear the sweet voice of the nightingale? The answer is in the oasis. Who takes rest in the shady places among the Arabian sands? The answer will be the tired travelers or the nomads. Last question. Whose song is more melodious than that of Nightingale's song? The answer is the song of the solitary reaper. So students, today we discussed the first three stanzas of the poem The Solitary Reaper. In the coming episode, we will discuss the remaining part of the poem. Till then, goodbye. Stay blessed.